rest of that thing, you know, muscles, tendons, ligaments, nerves, fingers, then go. All
right, try it again.
Is this like a mind thing? Like, am I just overthinking it right now?
Hey, what's up, guys? Johnny here. I got to go out with my friend Chad today and do some ministering to some people, praying for people, telling people about Jesus. And you're about to see two clips of two healings. And one guy, Peso, he was an awesome guy, super receptive. He was a believer. He got baptized when he was 12. And so I got to encourage him in his faith and just plant seed and just keep sowing into him. They recently lost a family member, so I got to pray with him about that and just command all, you know, to speak peace to him and command all negative thoughts away from him. And so that was an awesome experience. And then another guy, I got to pray for his ankle, who had been dealing with an ankle problem for about a month. And so I got to plant the seed of healing and plant the thought of a savior into his life. And I just encouraged him to get in touch. He said he had Christian friends, so I encouraged him to get in touch with his Christian friends and talk with him and tell them about what Jesus did for him. And what you don't see is we talked to probably like 50 people who said, no, I don't want to be prayed for. So a lot of people ask me, what do you do when people say no or they don't want to be prayed for? The Bible says to go house to house and find a person of peace. So, and then it says if they reject you, just shake the dust off of your feet and move on. So that's my encouragement to you. It's just if people say no and they don't want to hear about it, just move on to the next one. Look for someone who's receptive, a person of peace, someone who's going to receive what you have to offer them, which is Jesus, which is the message, the greatest message in the whole world, the most powerful message in the whole world, which is Jesus. Death, resurrection, and redemption for people who believe in him and make him Lord of their lives. So I want to encourage you, be used by God, be available to be used by God, and God will use you. God bless.
You can do it however you want.
All right, so what's your name?
Isaiah.
Isaiah, I'm John. You said you got pain in your ankle?
Yes.
How long have you had it for?
About a month.
About a month? On a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the worst, what's the pain at?
It's about 5 now.
5 now? All right, just pray for me. Right? In the name of Jesus, I command all pain to go right now. It could be healed in Jesus' name. All right, move it around. Let me know if you feel a difference.
Yeah?
Is it all gone, or did it go down? Or
it went down.
Okay, so what's it at now? Is that a 5?
A 3.
A 3? Uh-huh. All right,
is this like a mind thing? Like, am I just overthinking it right now?
Is it gone?
I'm scared to try to run.
Yeah, no, go ahead, man.
I'm scared to try to run.
Well, just do a fast walk then. Work it out.
Oh, I'm scared right now.
Is it gone?
Yeah, my overthinking.
Why are you not overthinking that? That's why we came up to you and asked if I could film and stuff. Like, I've seen hundreds of miracles and stuff, and that's why we do it, just because, like, Jesus in the Bible, he went around healing the sick and stuff, and he says that his disciples can do the same thing, like followers of him. He says, go preach the gospel and tell all I've commanded you to do. He said, these signs will follow my God, believe, they'll lay hands on the sick and they'll be healed. And then a couple other signs, but that's one of them. And so it's like a sign to you, he lets you know that Jesus Christ in the Bible, he's real. Died for your sins, he loves you, and he doesn't only heal bodies, but he did that as a sign because he wants you to know that he's available for you to have a relationship for you to forgive your sins and stuff too. So yeah, man, that's what it's all about. Isn't that awesome?
Yeah.
All my problems, migraine problems, back problems.
You have a migraine right now?
It's a slight migraine and back problems.
Okay.
And if you could pray for my family, because we just lost my mother this Friday.
Yeah, definitely. What's your name, man?
My name is Ryan, but I go by Peso.
Peso? All right, I'm John. All right, so you say you got lower back pain. On a scale of 1 to 10, out of 10 being the worst, what's the pain at right now?
Probably about a 7.
7? Lower back?
Lower back.
Alright, in the name of Jesus, I command all pain to go right now. Muscles, tendons, ligaments, nerves, be loosed in Jesus' name. Amen. Alright, move it around. Let me know if you feel a difference.
Actually, I do.
It was at a 7. What's it at now? Did it go down or is it gone completely? Or?
To be fairly honest with you,
yeah,
you did an impeccable job. It's gone, and now the other parts like, hey, me too, me
all
too.
Right, which parts? On the sides?
But like it really left. Yeah. Where the pain was at, it really left.
Yeah, I know that.
Like it was gone.
Definitely.
What else? So that means your faith really up there, because I believe in Jesus too.
It's Jesus, you know, man. It's all him, man.
He faith and prayer.
It's a sign to you to let you know that he's thinking about you, he loves you. You know, he wants your heart, you know? Like, he'll touch your body, but he wants your heart, so. What other parts of your body is hurting? Is that, like, on the sides, or?
The sides and the migraine is coming.
Okay, on a scale of 1 to 10, tell me numbers, what's the migraine at?
Probably, like, a 5, because my migraines, they be getting severe.
Alright, in the name of Jesus, I command all migraines to go right now. Command all any spirit of infirmity that's trying to move around in his back. In the name of Jesus, I command it all to go in Jesus' name, amen. Move your, let me know if you feel a difference in your head. Yeah?
Yeah, I feel a difference.
Or is that a 5? What's that now?
Probably like a 3. It's trying to diminish, but I'm having so many evil thoughts with my mother. All right, passing.
All right, let me pray for that too. All right, command that migraine to go. I speak peace right now to Peso. Peso, right? I speak peace right now to Peso. Supernatural peace. Lord, we just thank you for your comfort. Lord, you heal the brokenhearted, God. I just thank you for healing his broken heart. I pray for comfort and peace for his family, God. Lord, I just thank you for clarity and direction for him. Lord, I just thank you for an overwhelming supernatural peace of the power and presence of the Holy Spirit upon him right now, and peace in his mind. And any evil thoughts or lying thoughts, I command those to go from him right now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
How's it feeling now?
A lot better.
Cool, man. So you believe in Jesus? Yeah?
For sure. I've been baptized since I was 12.
Good.
Well, I don't know if we're supposed to get baptized in adulthood again.
Well,
I don't know.
I mean, you were 12, so you're like, you've made that decision. If you want to, like, if you feel like I want to remake that decision, you want to get baptized, that's totally fine too, you know? But, yeah, dude, just I'm here just telling you that Jesus loves you, cares about you, and he wants your heart, you know, completely. Maybe you were baptized when you were 12, and then you kind of like, I don't know if you've had a constant relationship with him or if you fell away a little bit. Or, you know, maybe he just wanted to rekindle that with him.
The thing is, I got a constant relationship with him.
Yeah.
I just choose to make
choices and stuff.
Right.
Yeah. I've been there myself, man. Like, I've had that constant relationship, and I've had ups and downs in my life, too. So I encourage you to just continue that relationship with him. And, I don't know, would you want to rededicate your life right now? I could lead you in a prayer, man. Just say a prayer and just say, Lord, just, I want you to, you know, be Lord of my life and first in my life. You know?
But don't you supposed to do that prayer if you're not really going to do other sinful things?
Yeah, so you're kind of waiting because you, I mean, if only if you were like, Lord, I want to make you first in my life.
Because I try my best not to lie to no human being.
Right.
You can't lie to God.
You can't lie to God, yeah.
So I'd be lying to sit here and say I'm going to turn my life all the way around.
Why don't you repeat this prayer after me? And we'll just say, ask God for help, you know, and grace. That sound good? I say, Dear Lord, I ask you for grace.
I ask you for grace.
And strength.
And strength.
In my life.
In my life.
I pray that you lead me.
I pray that you lead me.
And you become irresistible to me.
You become irresistible to me.
Where I can't sin.
Where I can't sin.
Without conviction.
Without conviction.
Thank you for just being Lord of my life.
I thank you for just being Lord of my life.
And just forgive me of my past sins.
And just forgive me of my past sins.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Well, I'll just encourage you, man. Just keep having that relationship with him. You know, keep talking with him. And just keep asking him for strength and for grace to be an overcomer, you know. And I'll do the same, you know. Like, I go through the same kind of life that you do. Like, we all have ups and downs. We all go through struggles. And
So I just want to encourage you, man. Appreciate Isn't that cool that he touched you today, though?
Yeah, for sure.
All right, peace, brother.
God bless.